Hi there! You are now watching Module 10, Unit 10.3 of this Delphi tutorial series for beginners. This lesson follows on Unit 10.1 and 10.2. It is important to watch those two videos before doing this lesson. In this lesson, we will explore some code again. We will use examples from this application that we started way back in Module 5. If you do not have the project, you must go back to Module 5 and follow the steps to finish it. Your project will work like mine when you are done with Unit 9.2. You can also download all the project files of Delphi examples that I demonstrate in these videos from patreon.com/LearnDelphi and search for the module or the unit. If a tutorial has downloads available, you will find the link at the bottom of the lesson. Click the link and download and extract the zip file to a location of your choice. I included a video folder and two project folders. There's a starter folder that you can use when I do a demo for that specific lesson. And there's a solution folder that contains a working project that you can use to compare your project with mine. Now, let's learn what a variable in Delphi programming is. I'll start with a story how I learned what a variable is. This is Miss Lynette. She was my first grade teacher when I was 6 or 7 years old. And she was so beautiful. Not only was she... Hold on! Sorry, that is not Miss Lynette. That's Mr. Killian. He was my grade 6 math teacher. But he only features later in this story. Ah, there she is. The sweet Mrs. Lynette. Beautiful, isn't she? All the boys liked her, but they all knew I will ask her to marry me one day. Not only was she sweet and beautiful, she was very smart too. She taught me, A is for apple. And that made a lot of sense. Every time a kid gave her an apple, she gave that kid an A. Then there was B for bee, easy. C for cat. Miss Lynette loves cats. And then D for dog. That makes sense. Who doesn't love doggies? But, fast forward a few years. You met him. This is Mr. Killian, my grade 6 math teacher. He was very impatient, and he was not as smart as the lovely Miss Lynette. He, in turn, taught me, A equals 3. How can that be? Miss Lynette say A is apple. But I'll let it go, he is not so smart. He also said B equals 5. I thought B is for B. I was lost. But then he did something very stupid and weird. He said X equals A plus B. Huh? Add an apple to a B. How's that? Then he wanted to know, what is X? I went, huh? And he got angry. His face went red. I was so scared and I was thinking very hard to recall what Miss Lynette taught me about X. Then I got it and I called out, oh, X is for X-ray. When I said that, Mr. Killian exploded. He screamed at me, no, it's a number. I think I also heard him calling me a potato, but I let it go. He is not so smart. Then I thought, if A and B are numbers, why don't I count the letters in the alphabet and find out what is X? So I started counting. 1. A is for apple. 2. B is for bee. 3. C is for cat. 4. D is for dog. And then I got to 23. 23. W is for warthog. 24. X is for X-ray. 24. X is for X-ray. X is 24, I shouted, very excited. But Mr. Killian didn't agree. He was getting so mad I could hear his heart beating like a drum. Well, I did learn a few important lessons that day. First, variables are placeholders with names like X, A or B. Second, Mr. Killian would be better off if he told me, from the start, that the answer is a number, or that it is a specific data type. I also learned that A is not only for apple, its value can change over time. For Mr. Killian, he got so excited that day, A changed from apple to ambulance. As for the lovely Mrs. Lynette, shame, she never got apples again, and I never asked her to marry me. I heard that she did settle down somewhere with her companion. This is a true story, but what is the moral of the story? And how does that fit in with Delphi? Do you remember the lesson in Unit 10.1 about data storage in Delphi? I mentioned there that we sometimes need to store values in memory. Well, that's the A's, B's and X's that represent values that we put in placeholders. In programming, those placeholders are declared as variables in memory. And do you remember the lesson in Unit 10.2 about data types in Delphi? There you learned that the value that you store must be of a specific data type, like a number or a date or characters. To Mrs. Lynette, it was the names of animals, fruit and hospital equipment. To Mr. Killian, it was numbers and hospital equipment. Now let's see what variables are in Delphi programming. Here I have a picture of a memory module. I also have several containers or placeholders that was declared as variables in memory. Each one of these containers are a specific data type. In other words, they can contain or store specific contents. Let's assume, for example, the paper bag only stores up to 500 grams of sugar. And let's also assume that this steel bucket contains up to 5 liters of water. Both of them can contain less, but 500 grams and 5 liters are the maximum capacity for these containers. You learned in Unit 10.2 that data types also have a maximum capacity or values in a specific range, just like these containers or placeholders in memory. We can also not throw the oil in the oil can into the sugar bag. Well, you can try, but the bag will not be able to contain the oil. In programming, we can also not store, for example, string values in integer variables. You can also not pour the water from the bucket into the sugar bag. That's another error. However, you can throw sugar into water. The sugar can mix with the water in the bucket, but not the other way around. Variables in programming are also like that. Some data types are compatible with each other, but some are not. For example, some data types, like integers and bytes, can be converted into strings to enable us to display numbers as strings. Some data types store the same kind of data. For example, both byte and integer data types store only whole numbers. The only difference is their size and the range of whole numbers that they will allow. An integer will therefore be like a bucket that can contain up to 8 liters of water, while a byte can only contain up to 5 liters of water. That means that the value in a byte is small enough to fit in an integer, but not the other way around. An integer's content may be too big to fit into a byte. Now let's talk about the characteristics of variables. Firstly, a variable is declared with a descriptive name that follows rules, and you may also apply a naming convention. Naming rules and conventions are covered in Unit 7.2 and 10.2. Here, on my memory card, I declared a variable called intAge. Notice the prefix int that indicates to me that this is an integer, and this variable depicted by the bucket will store an age in memory. Secondly, a variable must have a data type. If I declare this variable to be an integer, it will only save whole numbers from negative 2.1 billion to positive 2.1 billion. For the exact range, you can watch Unit 10.2 again. Thirdly, a variable will contain a value. You must only declare variables if you are going to use them, because they take up valuable space on your computer's memory. In my example, the integer called intAge will take a number as its value. Then finally, a variable has scope and duration. The scope is how widely the value in the variable is accessible in your program's code, or whether it can also be accessed by external units and programs. The duration is how long a value stored in a variable will be accessible to your program's code. We will cover scope and duration in more detail in the future. Now let's see how we declare and use variables in a Delphi project. I will explain it with this contact information project we developed over several previous modules and units. Here we have a form with various input components. In this lesson, I will only explain one of these inputs, and it is this one, the spin edit named SED age. We will cover all of them in a future exercise. Let's assume the user's age is 20 and we want to display a message box when the user clicks the display button. This is the message box we want to display. There are two important points I want to make here. Firstly, the value property of the spin edit is a numeric data type, while the message text is a string data type. To display the age, which is a number, as part of the message, which is a string, we must first convert the age to a string. Secondly, the value of the spin edit can be different from user to user. Therefore, the message will also differ every time a new age is given. So, remember my story. A can be for apple, but A can also be for ambulance. To display the message box, the user will click the display button. So we must write the code in the event handler for the on-click event of BTN display. This is the procedure that will handle the event. I'm sure you are familiar with event procedures or event handlers by now. All our variables that must be declared and processed when the user clicks the button must be declared between the procedure header and the begin statement, like this. The var statement is like an alarm that wakes up the memory card and tells it, "Hey, I need you to reserve some space for a variable." The var statement is followed by the name you want to assign to the variable. In this example, we call it BTE age, because we know that it will be a byte data type. That is followed by a colon. The colon means as, like BTE age as byte. The colon is followed by the data type. In our example, it is a byte. Now we will only be able to store a whole number from 0 to 255 in this variable. That will be perfect for our purposes, because humans can't be younger than 0 or older than 255. And always end your instruction with a semicolon. That's how we declare one variable in a procedure. This variable will now be accessible to all the code that I write for this event handler. Let's look at the message box again. The message is text, in other words, a string data type. We will therefore also need a string variable to contain the message. You can declare more than one variable with the same var statement by typing them on separate lines, like this. Here, I also declared a variable called strMessage as string. Also notice that I have another container in memory, but this one is different than the byte variable that I declared. Therefore, its contents or data type is different. The string container depicted by the paper bag is called strMessage because it will contain a message of type string. Now, let's look at the input again. We need to read the value from the spin edit called sedAge and store the number in the byte variable, in other words, in the bucket. This is the code. When we read the instruction from the back, it says, take the value property of sedAge and assign it to the byte variable called BTEH. The value is 20 and that will now be assigned to BTEH in memory. Therefore, the number 20 is now stored in the bucket. Now, we need to take the number in the byte variable and merge it with the words your age, followed by a colon and a space. We first must convert the 20 from a number to a string, then we concatenate it with the phrase. Notice the space between the colon and the closing single quotation mark. This is to provide for the space between the phrase and the number in the message box. Remember, your space bar is also a string character. Then, the concatenated phrase will be stored in the string variable depicted here by the paper bag. This is the instruction to do it. We take the value in the byte variable called BTEH and we first convert it to a string with the intoString function. That will now make the number a string. Another way is to call the toString method of the byte variable. Both of these examples will convert the number into a string. After the number is converted, it will be concatenated with this phrase, your age, followed by a semicolon and a space. The result will then be assigned to the string variable named strMessage in memory. In other words, it is now stored in the paper bag. Good. Now the message is prepared and ready to be displayed as output. We now use the showMessage function to receive the value in the string variable named strMessage as an argument. When the compiler executes this line, our string will display in the message box. We will do several lessons to unpack variables of different data types in the future. Before we see what's up next, just a friendly request. If this lesson was helpful to you, please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Also, share my content with your friends, classmates and colleagues on social media. Thank you, and thanks to my patrons on Patreon for your continuous support. Now, let's see what's coming up next. I'm sure you noticed already in this lesson that I'm using a logical methodology or workflow to make programming easy. That flow is called IPO, or Input Processing Output. In the next lesson, I will explain how you can also make it easy for yourself when you apply IPO. See you in the next lesson.